Hey guys, it's Zoe here, and welcome to 2017. I cannot believe that it is actually 2017. That's actually insane to me that 2016 is finally over. I haven't seen you guys or talked to you guys since, like, Christmas and, you know, like, right after Christmas. So I thought I would start the year off fresh with a planner video. And so, yeah, I wanted to start off the year with some kind of video that was like reflecting on 2016, and I didn't really want to do any favorites video or anything, and I thought I would do a 2016 planner flip through where I flip through all the different spreads and kind of talk about each one a little bit. But before I kind of start flipping through my 2015-2016 life planner, I wanted to show you guys my But yeah, so this is my new 2017 Erin Condren Life Planner. Sorry about the glare off the cover, but I got the watercolor floral cover with my name personalized right there. It's so pretty. I got the silver coil, and then, like, obviously the colorful inside, 12 months. So this is my 2017 one, and I absolutely love it. So let's get into the flip through. Okay, so this is my 2015-2016 Life Planner. This started in July of 2015 and ended December 2016, so it is 18 months instead of 12 months, so it's really fat, obviously, because I've been using it for a year and a half, and the cover won't even, like, yeah, basically it won't even lay flat. So I'm gonna flip to January, so that's what the monthly looked like. I'm not really gonna go into detail, but yeah, the first week in January was the Happy New Year week, obviously. It started, went from December 28th to January 3rd, and yeah, I went to New York for, like, a little mini birthday, like, pre-birthday trip, and it was super duper fun. And so yeah, I really like this week. The next week is my birthday week, my 16th birthday. It went from the 4th to the 10th. But yeah, this was a Scribble Prints Co., like, sample kit that I printed out some stickers to, like, go with it. And then the last kit, the New Year's one, was, like, a Scribble Prints Co. printable kit. But the next week, the 11th to the 17th, was inspired by the Scribble Prints Co. mystery kit from, like, Black Friday of 2015. Yeah, the Scribble Prints Co. mystery kit from the Black Friday of 2015. So yeah, that's that week. It's pretty uneventful. And then this week was made with some of the January monthly colors. It was the 18th to the 24th. And this was during, like, the blizzard of 2016 when we were missing a lot of school because of snow, and I stayed home a lot. So this week is January 25th to 31st, and this is when, this is like a pink and yellow kind of vintage Gypsy Road inspired floral, and, this is the week that we actually found the house that I am sitting in right now. This was before we left the house that I had the blue bedroom wall, so yeah, that is basically January. This is the monthly spread for February, yeah. Pretty pink and Valentine's Day. So for the first week, the 1st to the 7th, I did a Mardi Gras theme. And yeah, I really liked it. I thought it was super duper festive. And yeah, that was... For the week of the 8th to the 14th, I did a pink, blue, and red Valentine's Day theme that I took, like, Michael's sticker books and, like, washi, and I kind of just made it. This is also the week that Nick and Andrea, like, from Scribble Prints Co. got married. So that was pretty cool. And yeah, I really like this week. It's super lovey-dovey and cute. So the week after Valentine's Day, the 15th to the 21st, I kind of did a Valentine's Day rainbow theme with a bunch of kind of puns from Michael's sticker books, like, I'm nuts about you and we just fit, haha, get it? But yeah, I think it was super colorful and fun. And then the week after, the 22nd to the 28th, was kind of just like a monthly color theme, and I printed out my own stickers and just did my own thing. We won second place in our Winter Guard competition, which is pretty cool. And then we're on to March. This was the March monthly spread. I really liked it because I used Erin Condren letters to spell it spring break. I thought that was pretty cute. But the first week was the first ever sticker kit that I ordered from Scribble Prints Co. And it was the prickles, like, cactus themed one. And I thought it looked really good with the greens. But yeah, the 29th through the 6th was a hard week for my family because on the 1st, my little sister was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes and was in the hospital for actually 2 days. That's when she got home. But yeah, it was really hard. And even though I liked this week, yeah, it was just sad. But I mean, we're getting better and adapting to it, so that's good. The next week after that was kind of just a spring theme. I used some glam planner full boxes and then just some random washi and stuff from sticker kits and stuff like that, but it was just kind of like a really busy week. I didn't really fill it out much, but it was just kind of like a springy week. But yeah, that was the 7th through the 13th. The next week was a glam planner print printout, St. Patrick's Day theme. I also used some deco from sticker kits, but I really liked it. It was super fun and rainbowy and colorful, and yeah, I really enjoyed it. But yeah, the 20th was actually the first week of spring, technically, so that's cool. The next week was kind of an Easter kit. It was a glam planner printout as well, and I used some Easter deco from a Michael sticker book. And yeah, it's really super kind of pastel-y and pretty and soft and springy, and I really like it. That's the 27th, so yeah. Now we're moving into April. I absolutely love these colors. Purple and blue are my favorites, but I did a Tangled theme for this week, and yeah, I used some Tangled sticker that were from a Target sticker book, and yeah, I really liked this week. My favorite colors when it were in it, it was super springy, and I think it's super cute. So the next week, the 4th through the 10th, was this kind of like, I think I did it after Scroble Prince Co.'s April Mystery, and it was kind of like a April showers bring May flowers type vibe, and it was pink, purple, yellow, and green, and I thought they were super springy, and I used all these cute emoji stickers, and it was just really cute. Like, something about the color combo just, like, speaks to me. And then the next week, the 11th through the 17th, was when I moved into the house that I'm currently in. And yeah, so I've been here for almost a year, I guess, which is crazy. And I love these colors, obviously, because my favorite colors are purple and blue. I feel like I've said that a lot in this video. But yeah, and it's just so pretty. That's kind of one thing I miss about the old planner, is like the April colors, because they were like goals. And then, there's one more week in April. And I just did this week, it was like miscellaneous kind of multicolor Scroll Prince Co. ombre heart checklist, and then construction paper, and really anything I could find, because this week my internet was not working and I didn't have a functioning printer, so I couldn't print out anything on sticker paper, so I just used whatever I could find. And yeah, so moving on into May, these are pretty colors as well. So this spread was kind of a black and white granite marble theme, and I didn't really get to plan much in it. I didn't fill everything out. I was kind of just really busy with school and stuff, so that was an uneventful week from the 25th to the 1st. And then this week, the 2nd to the 8th, I also did not have time to fill everything out. As you can see on the weekend, it was kind of blank and I didn't do any like planning in the middle here. But yeah, it was still pretty colors. It was like a May colored spread. And this is when I kind of started to use a little bit more. Again, not a lot's filled out, but this was kind of modeled after one of her mystery kits and has a little hot air balloon, and the colors are really cute and springy. This is the week of May 9th to the 15th. I think my sister was like actually confirmed this week, which is cool. But yeah. Now this week I actually really like. This is the Scribble Prince Co. Pink geometric kit, and this is like a really old kit from Scribble Prince Co., but I absolutely love it. It's so cute, and I don't know, it's just everything about it. It was cool because this week was when I went to Busch Gardens for my band spring trip, and it was my sister Ellie's birthday. And so yeah, that was May 16th to the 22nd, and then this is May 23rd to the 29th. And yeah, I had a lot of standardized tests this week, so it wasn't the best week, but this is kind of like a video game spread, because my friend Jenna, it was her birthday, and she likes video games and Pokemon and all that stuff, so I decided to do kind of a spread that would maybe speak to her audience a little bit more. Anyways, now moving on to June. So June was the last month of school. So I love this kit. This is the Scribble Prince Co. I Love Donuts kit before it was reformatted. And yeah, there's just like a lot of donuts everywhere. It's a little bit messy and overwhelming, but I love it. So yeah, that was the spread of May 30th, Memorial Day to June 5th. And this is June 6th to the 12th, and this was like the June colors. And I love this so much. It is so summery, in my opinion. I love it so much. I love the watercolor kind of design in the background of the full boxes. It's so pretty. But yeah, that's that week. Then this is June 13th to the 19th, and I had some standardized tests, and I was just really stressed out because of school ending and all that stuff and grades. And so this is kind of like a rainbow kind of summery themed kit. I think it was also made in inspiration of a Scribble Prince Co. mystery kit.
And then the next week I love so much. It's so pretty. This is the By the Sea. So yeah, this is the By the Sea kit from the week of the 20th to the 26th. This was my last week of school and also the week that my sister was diagnosed with celiac, which is sucky. And yeah, it was just really nice, despite I had final exams. But yeah, I thought it was a really super cute summery kit, and it's one of my favorite kits that I've ever done. Now moving on into July, this is when I had my economics and personal finance course that I had to take over the summer, and I just did it during July. This was like the July monthly colors, and it was like glitter, and it was really pretty and summery and fun and bright, and my dad's birthday was on Monday, so that was the 27th through the 3rd. Then the 4th of July through the 10th, obviously I did a 4th of July theme. This was the Scribble Prince Co. kit, and it was a glitter, and I love it so much. It was so pretty, and one of my favorite spreads again. And then the 11th through the 17th, I did a beach theme, because my family was at the beach this week. And yeah, that's pretty self-explanatory. Then the 18th through the 21st, I copied another Scribble Prince Co. kit, and I did kind of like a preppy summery vibe, and I like these colors because they're unique and you wouldn't think to put them together, but they actually go together really nicely, and it's super preppy and cute. And then the 25th through the 31st, I did a galaxy purple Harry Potter theme, because this is the week that the Cursed Child script book thing came out, and I love it, and I did like a movie marathon every day with Harry Potter, and I had my EPF final, and yeah, that was that week, and it was super. Okay, so now that we're done with July, let's move into August. So the first week, well, the monthly, I basically had a marching band going on most of the month, but the first week was a Rio 2016 Olympics theme, and I did kind of like the colors from this, and I thought it looked really, really cute, and I loved watching the Olympics this summer, and I'm sad that it'll be another 4 years until I get to do it again. But yeah, that's August 1st through the 7th. Then August 8th through the 14th, I did a pink and green kind of watermelon theme, and I think it's super duper cute and summery and just really, really pretty, and I really liked that. Then this was my first week of marching band camp, so I was pretty busy, so I wasn't like spending a lot of time in my planner, but this is also my mom's birthday, and yeah, this is the 15th to the 21st, and this is the, I think it's called like the Amanda kit or something from Nicole Alexia Designs, and it's a matte kit, and I absolutely love it. The colors are so pretty because they're my school colors too, so that was pretty perfect. And then this is like a yellow kind of August color Minion spread. I think, yeah, because the Minions movie like just recently came out, and these were stickers from that sticker book. And, or like last year or something, I don't know, whatever. But it was really cute and summery, and yeah, I really liked it. It was a good way to close out August. And then now moving into September, obviously school started in September, which isn't really fun, but yeah. So this was my last spread of summer, and it was kind of a floral spread, and yeah. Okay, moving on. This was my back to school spread. I went back to school on Tuesday the 6th. This was the week of September 5th to 11th. And I used some of my leftover stickers from the Erin Condren Cool for School sticker book. And then I also used this washi that was like school themed. I think it was from Target. And yeah, it was really, really cute. I really liked it. It was kind of more minimalistic because it was like a lot of like white space and stuff like that. And then this is like a purple and blue kind of new September color, like geode thing, inspired by Scribble Prince Co. And I kind of tried out different lettering styles. And this was the week of September 12th through 18th. And so, yeah. Then this was like the old September colors. And I kind of used up some of my September stuff from 2015. And it's kind of like gray and purple. So I really like it. And I put goodbye September since this was like the end of September. The 19th through the 25th. And yeah, now into October. Here's the monthly. I love this spread so much. This is a Glam Planner printable from her printable shop. I don't think she does printables anymore, but yeah. And this was the Autumn Spice one. And this is, by the way, September 26th to October 2nd. My aunt's birthday was on Saturday. Also my first my second marching band competition. It was really rainy, which was why the little umbrella was cute, and I don't know, I love the colors, it's so fall and So October was really boring. The 3rd through the 9th, I did kind of an October colors, but I didn't really fill it out that much, so that's not very interesting. This spread was really cute. It was kind of like a woodland animals theme. That was the 10th through the 16th. Then I did like an endless sleep, like Squirrel Prince Co. inspired one, like a Halloween spread for the 17th through the 23rd. JMU, Parade of Champions, Memories. Then I did a kind of fun, kind of color poppy fall in love, haha, get it, like apple spread, I guess. And then for my actual like Halloween themed one, it goes from October 31st to the 6th, and this was the Witch Kit from Scribble Prince Co., and this was like pre-order exclusive, so not many people got it, and it came with the glitter headers, and I love it so much, with little ghosts, and it's so cute, and I love it so much. The colors are so pretty. And yeah, the cord's in the way. The next week was the 7th through 13th of November. This was the election week, and it was kind of hard on some people, but I did the Good Dinosaur theme. I actually have never seen the movie, but I thought it was really cute, and the colors were really cute. And yeah, it was kind of a spread where I used like leftovers from different kits and things like that. Then the next spread is the 14th through the 20th of November, and this was the old Scribble Prince Co. neutrality kit, and it was kind of more of a white space. So yeah, the 14th through the 20th was the neutrality Scribble Prince Co. kit, and it was just really cute, and I love it. Like, I think the colors are super neutrally and cute. Then the next week was really exciting because it was Thanksgiving week and Black Friday and all that fun jazz. It was the 21st through the 27th of November, and I think it's so fall and autumnal and pretty, and I love the colors. It's like so warm and cozy just thinking about it, the little leaf in the corner. And now on to my favorite month ever, December, which is obviously Christmas. And yeah, so the first week I did a kind of Let It Snow kind of spread, and I was really busy, so I wasn't able to like fully fill it out, and it was kind of like white space. Then the 5th through 11th of December, I did kind of a retro, kind of softer Christmassy theme. And again, I didn't have very much time to fill it out. It was kind of white space. And then the 12th through the 18th of December, I did a white Christmas theme, which is really pretty. And it was kind of inspired by a glam planner kit. And then obviously the most exciting week. Are you guys ready for this? I don't think you're ready for this. The week of Christmas. Yay! Look how pretty it is. This is the Candy Cane kit from Scribble Prince Co. And obviously, it's super Christmassy, and I love it so much. Like, what more would you want from a Christmas kit? It's literally perfect. And yeah, that just brings back a lot of nice memories. And then the last spread I have in this planner, the 26th. Yeah, so obviously this is the last week in my planner, the 26th of December through the 1st of January 2017. This was my New Year's Eve themed week. And yeah, there's not much more explanation to that. And that concludes my 2016 planner flip through. Now, I do have to apologize because obviously this would have made a lot more sense if it had gone up January rather than February. And I'm sorry that I haven't made a video or been on here since my What I Got for Christmas video, and it's been over a month. And I'm really sorry about that. I've just been really, really busy with school and like literally everything going on in my life. It's been actually really insane. And I'm really trying, and hopefully, you guys liked this video. Hopefully you guys liked it. Leave any video requests down below. My next video is probably gonna be a winter 2017 favorites video, and yeah, I hope you liked it. Comment, like, subscribe. Bye, guys!